Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our first time single take honest reaction to three songs in this one video. We are going to react to YouTube first up, and it's a request of our patron Ian. Where the Streets Have No Name is the name of the song. I'm kind of looking forward to it because I like the title of the song. Yes.
I remember hearing this song maybe 25 years ago. It's been a while. It's been a long time. I don't even remember much of it.
What it is, okay?
Don't remember much of it. There are a couple of songs of YouTube I remember till today, having heard them years ago. One is, I still haven't found what I'm looking for. That's an interesting song.
Nice titles, no? I like those.
Yeah, and I think this is from the same album, maybe, or maybe a few years later.
Okay.
Where the Streets Have No Name. So, possibly from the 80s.
What we are going to do here during this reaction is, Savio has somewhat heard the song. He may have some memories. While the song is going on, he will remember more things. But for me, it's first time going to be listening to this song of U2. To be honest, I had not even heard there was a band called U2 before we started our reactions, and so was the case with so many other bands and even big bands. And that's how things are with a lot of Indian people. They don't know much about Western music, and a lot of people don't even watch Western music, movies as well. Western as in not Western, Western, the Hollywood movies or things from outside, because we have a lot of entertainment, a huge entertainment industry in our country itself, and then in different states also we have different things going on in the regional languages. So what I like is listening to the music for the first time, get the feel of it, get to understand what exactly it's about, how good it is, or the things that I like about it. And then after the reaction, after listening to the song, we discuss the things that we like. If the lyrics are something pertinent, something important, has a good message, we like discussing that too. So that's what we will be doing in this reaction of U2 and the other two songs, requested by our patron Ian.
Yeah, let's get started with this. Maybe we'll have a lot to talk about, maybe not, who knows,
okay,
with U2. So U2, Where the Streets Have No Name. Thank you. Okay.
Wow. What an amazing way to sing the song. Bono, you said, right?
Bono. The songwriters are listed, but they don't include him unless, I don't know his actual name. But the songwriters are listed as Adam Clayton, Dave Evans, Larry Mullen, and Paul Musson.
Yeah.
This is as per Lyric Find.
Hmm.
They usually get it right.
Okay.
Yeah. What is your take on it as a first time listener?
I like the song, I like the music and the way he sang it. The moment he started singing, I said, wow. It was, very passionate singing. The passion could be heard in his voice. That's what I like about the vocals. The way he sang was a perfect way to sing the song. I don't know if the lyrics are that hard-hitting, but the way he sang it makes it very, very hard-hitting. You know, it has a double impact of the lyrics. Even the lyrics seem to be okay, as far as I can see. We have had more hard-hitting lyrics than this. So the lyrics are okay, but the way it was sung and the way the music was performed, the music was getting more and more intense, you know, progressing as it goes, as if it's moving, you know, motion-like music with the guitar tunes and the bass guitar tuning in beautifully together. The music was in unison and so was his vocals with the music. It was a great first time.
This line, where the streets have no name, has been repeated quite a few times in the song.
Times, yeah.
What do you think it means, or what is he talking about? Is he talking about places where, you know, you're not labeled, you're not judged, the love that you have, your relationship, maybe it's a gay relationship, maybe it's something that is not, what was considered normal
or good, okay,
or usual back then.
Yeah.
So is it like that, or is it something else? What is your take on it? Even if it's right, even if it's wrong, what is it?
I might be wrong, but I thought it was, he's probably talking about towns or the town where he is at the moment, where a lot of hatred is there in general. There's a lot of problems, a lot of hatred, a lot of differences among the people. The poison rain says probably it's somewhere there's unrest as well. Think people may be getting injured or hit off and on and things like that, and he wants to get out of there and he wants to be out there with his partner, and that's the best he can do. He is not saying he wants to change the scenario here. He's saying last line was, this is what I can do, run out of here, move out of here, because this is affecting both of us, this is affecting our relationship as well. So he's talking about love is getting the rust and things like that, probably because of the influence of the surroundings. And he wants to get out of there, he wants to have a better place where all these differences are removed, where all these problems, all the hate and fights don't matter. Where people don't judge each other, people are not against each other. And that happens, this kind of feeling occurs very often if you actually interact with people who spread hatred so much that it's beyond your capacity to take in or beyond your capacity to process. Sometimes we do reactions to certain songs where the reaction may be an honest reaction. I won't say a critical one. I will say it was honestly that way, what we felt, we talk about it. But in response, the kind of comments come not because of the cause that the song was talking about. Recently, we had done a reaction to a shipwreck song. We didn't really criticize the tragic event, but we said what exactly, how it was sung and etc. And the way people were mocking bigger tragedies. Is that how we are supposed to be talking about tragedies? Is that how we are supposed to mock tragedies? I don't think. But I guess that's the difference. That's the difference. And that's what he wants to run away from.
We are not going to run away from that.
Yeah, he's saying that's what he can do.
We are not going to run away from things.
Yeah.
If that's what he's running away from, running away from everything is not a solution to the problems.
Yeah. He wants to hide, he wants
it
to run.
It may be tough to stay put. Yeah. But what is much more needed is to fight back. And fight back not through violence. Do it the Gandhian way, through non-violence.
There was the line in 6 a.m. Song, Skin, and that said, kill them with your kindness.
Kill them with kindness. I won't go that far also.
Yeah.
Yeah, but definitely running away from problems is not the solution. And if that's what this suggests, he wants to go to where the streets have no name and go with her or him, that is not going to solve your problems, because wherever you go in the world, whether it's India or Ireland, America or Antarctica, there are going to be people who may disagree with your point of view. Not everyone will agree with you.
Yeah.
U2 is one of Ireland's biggest export, one of the foremost being whiskey, the Irish whiskey to be precise.
Irish coffee?
Irish whiskey. Irish coffee also has a dash of whiskey.
But that's no coffee, right?
Yeah, but U2 is one of Irish biggest exports when it comes to music.
Okay. Whether
or not this song is the best reflection of their sound, that is, and their thought process while writing it, that is for all of us listeners to understand and analyze and make up our own minds on.
Yeah.
I personally like the music and the way of singing, not so much the lyrics, if that is what it means, based on our interpretation. We'll move on to the next song, Where Is My Mind by the Pixies, after a quick break.
Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our reaction to My Chemical Romance. And this song, Welcome to the Black Parade. Welcome to the Black Parade. I don't know which parade it is going to be. It seems something controversial.
Who knows? You know, when it comes something to controversial lyrics, with no one really, very few people on YouTube
are open to things.
Are open to our response to it or honesty in our reactions.
Yeah.
It's not that we have anything against the lyrics most of the times, but just for being honest, we are targeted. So yeah, it's not really the right platform to request songs like these. If it is a controversial song,
I don't know, I'm just guessing.
You know, you should not be requesting it to us in the future. Definitely don't request controversial songs to us, because it's not the right platform to, you know, for us to give that response on. It's not really perhaps it is taught in certain parts of the world and certain cultures not to respect someone else's opinion, or even if it's very, very valuable opinion, an experienced soul reacting to that music, or even a young mind who has a lot of cultural input to add to the song, yet it is disrespect. So that's how the platform is, and really nothing much is done. I guess that's how it's possibly a reflection of a part of the world, actually not the whole world definitely, but a part of the world. Welcome to the Black Parade by My Chemical Romance. Not expecting much from this, to be honest.
When I was a young boy, my father took me into the city to see a marching band. He said, "Son, when you grow up, would you be the savior of the broken, the beaten, and the damned?" He said, "Will you defeat them, your demons, plans that they have made? Because one day I'll leave you a phantom to lead you in the summer to join the Black Parade." We'll be right back.
definitely the strongest song out of the three. Lyrically, vocally, even musically. Wow, this was quite a surprise. I thought it would be something controversial. But it turned out to be quite inspiring by the end of it all. Very inspiring, so much detail in the lyrics. It just went on and on and on. This was beautiful. The songwriters are mentioned as Frank Iero, Gerard Way, Michael Way, Raymond Toro and Robert Breyer. This is as per Lyric Find. And wow, what beautiful lyrics this one had.
Lot of content and not too much of repetition.
Yeah, even reading it would take five minutes.
Yeah, long.
5 minutes.
Yeah, it was managed well by the My Chemical Romance. Yeah.
Hmm. So what do you have to say about it? Anything about the vocals, the music or the lyrics?
I like this song. I like the sound of it. I like the marching drums and the sound of that. I like the way it started. It gave enough space for people to get ready for it. He started it with very hard-hitting, very passionate vocals and then came in the marching drums while he was discussing that he went for the parade and this, that. And then from there, the music went on and with hard-hitting vocals. I like the way they created this song. But also, there is one thing that I would admit that I don't get all of it. I really don't get all of it. Which event it is, what is this black parade and things like that, I don't know. He was talking about she went up, I mean someone in his life, probably his mother I'm guessing because he came out with his father only. She is dead and then after that he's saying we'll carry on. I would, he won't go to join but he'll carry on in this life, something like that. Then there was, father was telling him to fight against all the demons and things like that and all non-believers. And things like that. So I don't get the plot of the story where it all began. What's the base?
Yeah, it doesn't take into consideration that there may be people from a totally different part of the world with a different background, different culture.
They may not have seen.
They may not have a clue what is going on here.
Yeah.
To start off only, we thought it was something maybe about, when it called Black Parade, we thought it might be about the black community. Something like that, you know.
I don't think that
but it wasn't the case. It doesn't seem to be the case.
Hmm.
But nothing was there in the lyrics which told us
clear cut
what is going on here.
Hmm.
It says it started off with in a clear way, but then it was all over the place.
Hmm.
When I was a young boy, my father took me into the city to see a marching band. He said, son, when you grow up, would you be the savior of the broken, the beaten and the damned? So I like all that.
Yeah.
He said, will you defeat them, your demons and all the non-believers? The plans that they have made because one day I'll leave you a phantom to lead you in the summer to join the Black Parade.
Mm.
So from these lines, it suggests that the Black Parade is like all the people who are dead. Who are dead and gone.
Yeah.
Their spirits may be there lurking around the place. Mm. Like Day of the Dead in Mexico that is celebrated in a very significant and big way.
Mm.
So it suggests something like that. But can we be sure? He does continue to talk about his mother. She is watching over me and other times I feel like I should go. And through it all, the rise and fall, the bodies in the streets. And when you're gone, we want you all to know. We'll carry on. And through, though you're dead and gone.
We will be telling the dead parents we will carry on. That's all it should be.
It's like a song, perhaps like a celebration of the Day of the Dead.
So it should be,
Something like that, those lines.
Yeah.
But it's not clear. It's not really clear. We can't get it right away, that's for sure. But brilliantly, still it is the best of the three.
Very well done.
I would definitely say, out of these three, even you two, this was better than that.
Mm.
The way it was sung, the way it was written, the way it flowed, the musical arrangement, everything was way better and it was not so repetitive as the U2 or the Pixies songs were.
Yeah, yeah.
So the hats off to them.
Pixies is a misfit here.
Yeah.
Among these three, Pixies is a misfit.
Yeah, U2 had that catchy tune and of course the vocals.
And great vocals. Great vocals, great music and good lyrics. But Pixies, wonder.
I like these lines and I'll read it out before we wind up.
Okay.
I'm unashamed. I'm gonna show my scars.
Nice.
I like that line. That says a lot, you know, for different people. That connects with me, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
And connects with me on this platform as well as an Indian.
Mm-hmm.
It connects with me wholeheartedly. Wow, that's a good line.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's about it for this set of videos for our patron Ian.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
Good request. Thank you for watching.